Hard Rockology Show, Chris and Matt. That's the latest from Barbecue Barbies. The song is called Babylon from their new album, Driven. And I want to welcome back to the show singer, songwriter, Nikki Rock. Nikki, thanks for taking time out to talk to Hard Rockology yet once again.
Hello. Really nice to be back talking with you guys. How are you?
Doing great. How are you?
I'm really good, thank you. All good. Yeah.
I have to comment on the album cover right off the bat. I mean, everybody's jumping up and down. It looks like everybody's very happy on the album cover. But, of course, the album I'm talking about is the new one you just put out, Driven. Tell me a little bit about the album cover right off the bat.
Well, it was actually, I think it was our drummer's idea. She thought it would be fun to do something that is not, you know, just our face shots or, you know, basic normal boring covers that you just stand in a line. So we sort of wanted to just be like, yeah, let's have fun and jump up in the air. And it was really fun taking the photo shoot as well, doing it. I mean, it took a long time to get it, everyone to be up in the air at the same time. And we ended up having to cut everyone, I think, separately anyways, because it was pretty hard, and it was a windy, cold day. So it was a lot of fun. And then we ended up with that. And yeah, so we were pretty happy with it.
All right, Nikki, I've had a chance to listen to the entire album, and I will say this, I think this is probably, out of the three releases you sang on, this is probably the best release so far for you guys, so congratulations. I think it's
Thank
a great
follow-up. Thank you. Thank you. We were aiming, that's always what you try to do is, you know, you want, it was pretty hard writing it, because it's like, you're trying to make it better than the first and the second album altogether, you know, so you wanted, you know, the third album has to be better, it can't go back, you know, you have to go forward and step up a bit. So I'm happy you like it. Thank you.
Yeah, and I also want to sit there and say as well, you guys are one of the few bands that can actually make a serial killer song really cool to listen to. So I have to ask you that Queen Deadly is probably one of my favorite tracks on the album as well. So I mean, really,
cool.
I mean, take us into the process of writing that song, because you don't see, especially a band like you guys, which is what I would call really good party hard rock music, good time music, to go ahead and do a female serial killer song. So what was that about?
Well, it was actually started out like that. Our solo guitar player, Kaisa, she's married to Basie, who is the guitarist for 69 Eyes. And he wrote a few tracks, and then I had to listen to one of them, and I'm like, okay, I like this one. And then I started writing the melody for it. So he just had a track. And so I basically came up with an idea for it, and then I worked with him on that track, and then I took in some co-writers to write with me, because I wanted to make it a bit different, not just like normal, you know, write about a love story or anything. So I wanted to write a bit about, you know, a female killer, and you know have a little bit fantasy in it. So yeah, it was a lot of fun doing it, so I'm happy you know you like it, and it turned out the way it did, so it's fun.
Matt, you don't think Nikki's a closet serial killer when she's not on stage singing, do you?
Well, it sounds like she said it was a fantasy to write the song. So.
Yeah,
exactly. Maybe it might be just my fantasy. Yeah, I might be talking about myself. Yeah, you never know.
That's true. You put out like three videos already for the album. I want to talk about Under My Skin first, and then we'll talk about the other two. Tell me a little bit about that one. I need to know who the guy in the trunk is at the end of the video.
Oh, that's that's a friend of mine, actually. Yeah, it was a really fun video to shoot. We wanted to make it a little bit, like, bold and the beautiful, like, you know, and, like, you know, filmed that way. And, you know, because rock music is not, of course, you have to take it in one way serious, but it's also a lot of fun. So we wanted to make it sort of, you know, just like a type of comedy thing out of that. You know, the song is not comedy written, but we wanted to make, you know, a fun video. So yeah, so we just put on a few wigs and had a lot of fun, and yeah, that's what happened.
Well, in the first video that you guys put out, or actually more recently, Babylon as well, which is also the first track that you released off the album, can you tell us a little bit more about that particular track? It's like one of those tracks for me, the more you listen to it, the better the track.
It grows on you.
It does grow on you.
It's growing right up his back right now.
Yeah, it's growing right up my back.
Super. Well, basically, that's a track we worked in the rehearsal room, just the band together. And so it was basically started out with just jamming, and then we just started writing it. And then our drummer came up with, she was like, oh, we have to write about Babylon, and like, that sounds so good, and like, take me to Babylon. And then I started writing the rest of the lyrics around that subject, and yeah, that was also a really good fun song to do. And in the video is basically because we have our friend who was following us around when we did gigs for like 2 years, so he's been filming a lot, you know, from backstage and, you know, from the stages and stuff. And then I suggested to him, like, why don't we do like a road trip video type for one of the songs? And then we came up to do about from the Babylon song to do, you know, that, so he cut together pieces from some tours and stuff. And yeah, so he added it up, you know, in a day, and then we had Babylon video. So yeah.
I was gonna say that's a fantastic video to watch. I mean, the song is great in itself, but then you watch the video and you get like a kind of a behind the scenes look at what's going on with you guys when you're on tour. And who's the person who filmed it again? What's his name?
Juha Hanhinen.
Yeah, he did a fantastic job, and then the editing of it too is really good. I mean, it's like, I'm a rock fan. I want to see bands play and see that, what they're all about. And
yeah.
I think the video pretty much tells everybody who you guys are all about. You're having fun, you're playing live, what it's like on the road. It's a really good video. If you haven't seen it yet, you got to check it out.
Cool, thank you. I'll tell him hi from you. And yeah, I mean, he's the guy who's been doing most of our videos now. He did Gun in My Hand, and then he did the Driver's Seat video and the Stone Cold video, which we put out last Friday. So we've been using him a lot because he sort of, you know, if we have an idea, he can really put it out. So he listens to us, and really easy guy to work with, and yeah, just super talented young guy. Yeah,
he seems like he likes working in black and white a lot, and I think that brings more to the video. I like that.
Yeah, I think but the last video we did was actually, it was our drummer's idea, so she was the one who wanted to do like a black and white video for Stone Cold, and so she was basically working with him through the whole video process, so that's basically them two who made that video. It came out good.
Yeah, it did come out good, and I wanted to mention, you did mention a track off the previous album, Gun in My Hand, and then,
yeah,
I mean, a comparable track, or I would say the most similar track on the new album is Stone Cold, and if you look at those two tracks, they're pretty, I mean, there's a lot of meaning behind those tracks. So what's going on with Stone Cold? Like I've mentioned previously, it's probably my favorite track on the album. So what's that song all about? And then the video that accompanies it.
Well, let's say, well, I think Stone Cold probably talks about, you know, if you have a breakup, and I actually had a breakup like a year ago or something. So I was a bit influenced maybe writing from that, and just basically, you know, writing about, you know, you feel bad and, you know, if something is over or whatever, and it's a powerful song in a way, and it means a lot to me, that song. And it was me and the guitar player Geisa who wrote that, just sitting at my place drinking red wine and having a laugh, and then so that's how the song came out. And then we took it to band practice, and then we just basically did that song with the whole band. So, and then the music video was then our drummer and Juha Hanhinen who put together, and we basically wanted to, so you see our face expressions and just basically, you know, showing sorrow, frustration, all those things. And so that was just basically the idea of the whole thing, you know, that is a powerful, you know, sort of meaning. And then because the video is made the way it is, it's easier for the song to sort of have justice. So you can also listen to the song while watching the video, so the video isn't too complicated.
And it's got a classic ending to it, too. I mean, water always cleanses everything, and it's classic at the end when everybody gets get the water
exactly.
on them. But, I mean, it's a very powerful song, and the video is very powerful, too. And it's like, I've never seen a video like this before. And that's what I like about it. I mean, Matt and I watch a lot of videos, and you see a lot of the same things over and over again. But when you see a video like this, it's kind of like, wow, that's pretty cool. It's worth a mention that if people haven't seen Barbecue Barbie videos, definitely go check them out on YouTube.
Now, Nikki, let's go ahead and talk again about Driven, the new album. I mean, like I said, I think this is your best release so far. So you had mentioned going into this thing, was there a lot of pressure on you and the band to sit there and say, you know what, we could do something that we've always done? Or, I mean, what was the thought process coming into writing this album?
Well, it was pretty difficult. Like I said, that it's, you know, I was trying to prove Or the whole band was probably trying to prove, you know, that we can make, you know, better songs and, you know, better music than the first album and second album all together. So there was like a lot of pressure because they say if the third album doesn't success, then, you know, if there's not success, then you sort of, you know, what's the point in continuing? So, of course, we wanted to do the best job that we could. And for me, writing the lyrics as well, I think I was struggling with them and tearing my hair away almost, you know.
Was there a particular...
Stressing because, you know, you really want to make a really good job. Yeah.
So is there a particular track on the album that you're really... I know you've mentioned Stone Cold being one of them, but is there another track on the album that you're really proud of, that you're saying, yeah, I really like this track and it's currently in our set list?
There's many, but Incomplete is also, like, one that I really like singing. It's sort of, you know... Also emotional song, but powerful anyways. And well, basically I'm happy with, you know, the whole album in general. Like I feel good with it. I feel like I can say I'm proud that we did this. So there's not one song or two songs, but of course you always have a few that is like, you know, you're more excited about maybe doing at a show or something. But anyways, we're excited about just to get out and play all these new tracks because, I mean, we've been waiting for a long time to do it. So we're really happy that it's done and everything went great in the studio and now it's out. And so, yeah, we're really hoping just that the rest of the world is going to hear it. So we're waiting for that still to hopefully one day happen.
Hard Rockology Show, Chris and Matt, we're talking with Nikki Rock of Barbecue Barbies. Nikki, what's the plans for the band moving forward, late 2015, early 2016? Any plans to hit the United States? I know it's a expensive proposition, but just kind of curious.
Well, we really hope to do that. Yeah, it is. It's the money who is the biggest issue. And at the moment, we don't have a distribution company for this album, so we're trying to still look. So if there's anyone out there, give me a ring. but yeah, so we haven't released the album basically in Europe yet. So it's only been released in Finland. So we're really trying hard now to search for some deals that we can release it abroad. And the plan, of course, hoping to do lots of festivals in the summer. But now we toured Finland already. So, and we still have a few shows coming up here. But then sort of, I think we're waiting for... hoping that after basically in the beginning of next year or summer that something more is going to happen, but still, yeah, we're not really sure.
So you can get the new album Driven it's on iTunes. Where's the best place to get it?
It's on iTunes and yeah, you can buy it online and basically yeah, you can check out our website. We have info where you can buy it, barbecuebarbies.com. And or our Facebook page or anything. And just you can ask questions. We always answer as soon as we have the time. And so yeah. So you can get it pretty easily in Spotify and basically it's everywhere. And there's lots of videos out. So yeah.
And if you want to check out what the band looks like, I believe you're also on Instagram, correct?
Yeah, we're on Instagram. We're everywhere. Yeah, exactly.
All right, Nikki, Matt, you have anything else you want to add or pretty much covered it, right?
No, I was just going to sit there and say for our listeners and out there, the only place you can buy the album right now here domestically is on iTunes and on Amazon. It is available, so I recommend definitely picking it up. It is a great album, so I recommend definitely taking the leap and putting Barbecue Barbies into your queue, into your musical rotation. Yeah, now I do want to say this. I do think you have one of the better female fronted voices right now currently in rock. I'm not just saying next year on the phone but I'm serious. I mean, there's a lot of female fronted bands out there right now. And I definitely think you have one of the better, I mean, you have a very unique voice, especially on the new album. You're doing some different stuff vocally that I really enjoyed, that really stood out to me.
Oh, thank you so much. I was really trying to, you know, you always try to make everything a bit better. So, you know, been practicing or then, yeah. Practicing and drinking more, so my voice was rougher. No, I'm just joking. But yeah.
Now, you know, I think there's some truth behind that, Chris. What do you think?
I think so. It could be the serial killer in her, too. You never know.
It could be. You never know. You never know.
So before you go out serial killing, what exactly are you drinking? I'm assuming you're not drinking red wine. Well, maybe she is drinking red wine.
I love red wine, definitely. But we have our rider backstage. We have red wine, white wine. We have beer. I mean, there has to be beer. And then we have cider. And then usually we have one of these stronger stronger, like, rum type of a Finnish one called Jallovina. It's like a really famous thing.
What kind of beer?
Yeah, I was going to sit there and say, what's the chosen choice beer for barbecue?
Finnish beer. That's like really good beer. Yeah, well, basically, we're not so picky of what's in the backstage. Like, as long as we get like some kind of drink, but it has to be, you know, good or basically beer. But Finnish beer is usually always good.
All right. Any recommendations?
Well, there's Karhu is a good beer. Bear beer. So, yeah. So, Karhu is one. It's one of my favorite ones.
The official drink of barbecue Barbies. I like it.
Yeah.
Karhu. Yeah.
you could have her do it. She could do a commercial for the beer company pretty soon, and then you get the money.
I know. We should get free beer from them. Yeah.
Exactly. Try to get a sponsor. That's a great idea. Why not? Everybody's like doing in the U.S. cold cock whiskey. I mean, you guys should do the sponsor for the Finnish beer. Why not?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, another quick question before I let you go.
Yeah.
Because you did Shut the Fuck Up on the last album, which was a really different track. I would say almost poppy in nature, okay? Actually, I like the track. Mm-hmm. I mean, is that something you guys are steering away from, or do some of the fans out there, I mean, it's because there's nothing like that on the new album, or is that just the one-and-done type of track that you guys did on the last track?
Well, it was sort of one. I wouldn't mind doing more tracks like that. So, I mean, it was like probably one of the most famous song, at least here in Finland, the Shut the Fuck Up. And of course, like some radio stations abroad didn't play because of the F-U-C-K word, but otherwise, you know, it was pretty popular. But probably in the same kind of meaning, we wrote the sexual frustration, but of course it doesn't have the same groove in it. But I think we probably, hopefully we're going to write a bit more of that kind of tracks as well, but it just didn't come up like a song like that this time.
I think mixing it up, I think it was like one of those interesting tracks that was on the album. So like I said, I'm looking forward to whatever it is that you guys are putting out. And like I said, hopefully you guys get some distribution for the new album and it gets out.
I know. So hopefully soon, because I can't wait to go abroad and do some shows. So, but let's hope.
All right, Nikki, like we do with all of our guests, why don't you go ahead and introduce another track off of your new album, Driven. And take us out of the interview.
Okay, well, this track is one of my favorite tracks, and it's called Stone Cold.
A crimson clover spread across the floor. You had to push me to get what for. This frozen silence and my shallow soul. No, I'm not running, got nowhere to go.